Well, welcome to the new book review. This time it's a little Puritan paperback called The Heart of Christ by Thomas Goodwin. These Puritan paperbacks are put out by the Banner of Truth Trust. And the idea is to just give you a little sample of something, of bits of these Puritans, because the Puritans write enormous amounts and the, you know, collected works can be 10 volumes, 12 volumes, 20 volumes, and big thick volumes, and it's quite intimidating to even dip into these. But there's lots of treasures in the Puritans. Who are the Puritans? Well, that was a kind of movement that lasted maybe almost 100 years from the late 16th century through to the end, towards the end of the 17th century. And it was, they got this nickname Puritans because they were kind of seeking purity in individual life and church life. They had a zeal. And then they sometimes get sort of pictured in popular culture as very, like, killjoys. They hated anything that was fun. There is a bit of that about them at times because they tried to ban Christmas when they got political power, and that's a bit depressing. And so there's some truth to some of the caricatures of them, but on the other hand, not always. And there was lots of them that were, some of them were into fashion and full amazing characters. And what I like about them isn't so much the political and cultural stuff, because some of that, like where they killed the king, and that was really bad. I mean, really dodgy. I mean, that's clearly against the Bible. So it's not that, but they did have a kind of zeal for the living God, and that's what I like about them. So that comes across in their books, this kind of passion and zeal that nothing matters so much as the living God, the Lord Jesus Christ, eternity. So this one, The Heart of Christ by Thomas Goodwin, it's very popular at the time. Thomas Goodwin is the man I did my PhD on, and it's really dealing with that thought that it would have been great to have met Jesus in the flesh, when, like, if to have lived like 2,000 years ago and being able to just meet him. Because when you read the Gospels, anyone just goes up to him and he deals with their problems, and he's got great compassion for them, understanding, he understands them. And, you know, anyone who met him and wanted help from him, they got it, because he just seems so approachable and so compassionate, so full of love for people. And then the feeling that people sometimes have is, oh, but now he's sort of caught up in the highest heaven and he's just not quite so approachable. So what Thomas Goodwin shows is, no, it's in fact that same heart, human heart, full of love and compassion and gentleness and kindness that he had in the Gospels as he was walking around among us here on earth. He has that still in the highest heaven, and the spirit that gave him all that compassion still is with him now, and now he's kind of more accessible to more people because of the ascension. So it's really kind of, it's an invitation to draw near to Jesus with confidence and know that he has a heart for us, a human heart that beats for us human beings. It was very popular at the time, and it's a great introduction to Thomas Goodwin. It's not always easy to read Thomas Goodwin, but this is a great little start. And all these Puritan paperbacks, not all of them are amazing. There's one or two I'm like, oh, that's not as good. But by and large, there's a lot of these in the series. I don't know, there may be 30 or 40, I don't know. There's quite a lot. I have them all, I think. And most of them are really, really good. Really good. And they stir you, comfort you, challenge you, inform you. And they're quite cheap and easy to read, and often are in sort of slightly more modern English. So that's my one I'm recommending. Thomas Goodwin in the Puritan paperback, The Heart of Christ.